Hey, what's up? It's Madeline. This is Wine Folly, where we learn by drinking. Now, today is a great day to pour yourself a glass of wine. Why you say that, Madeline? Well, today is 2020, a year of wine in review. So to prepare for this video, I poured myself a glass of wine, and then I looked up all the news stories that happened in 2020 around the topic of wine, and there were a lot. So if you want to get the full details, definitely check the comments. I will link to the article that has all the information along with the source links. Very difficult to drink this way. This year really started out with a big sad face, and that was because at the end of last year, the governments around the world started initiating tariffs on wine. The US leveled up a second round of tariffs against European wines, which for some reason has something to do with like Airbus and Boeing. And why wine is involved with that, I have no idea. So Europe was like, oh yeah, you don't want my wines? Well, I'm going to China. And then China in turn was like, oh, I'm getting all this sweet European wine. I'm gonna smack a big ass tariff on Australian wines because, you know, who cares about them? Drink Australia, my friends. Finally, the South African government shit the bed during COVID and initiated a no exports whatsoever on the burgeoning South African wine industry. And by the way, that's like cutting a $5 million industry in half. So the good news is, total wine sales are up. In fact, they're up by a massive amount. During the major COVID crisis between about April and about June, we started buying wine like crazy. In fact, I'm pretty sure this picture sums up everyone's entire opinion about 2020 in general. We weren't buying high quality wines this year. We were buying big brand garden variety basement wines and just drinking them out of the box. So those small independent wineries had to get super creative this year just in order to survive. In Italy, they have these like plague era service windows all around Tuscany, and they open them back up as a great way to do curbside pickup for wine sales. One winery practicing social distancing strapped a bottle of wine to their dog to do a door delivery. It has no nose. Now, we've talked about climate change before on the blog with this epic study that came out talking about how wine regions were gonna change maybe by the year 2050, but 2020 is when we actually saw some major changes that have terrified us all. Germany experienced yet another warm, mild winter, so no ice wine from them. And then California and Oregon got hit massively by wildfires. Some of the worst air quality reports in the entire world were happening in Napa and in Southern Oregon's wine regions. Wineries burnt down, people lost their homes. It is an extreme situation, and sorry to say, it's only gonna get worse. That makes me pretty thirsty. Oddly enough, wine in the world right now is in a massive surplus, especially in the United States of America. And what are we doing with all this wine? You would think it would get passed down to the consumers and we'd be saving lots of money on wine. But no, I have seen a mysterious boon on accidental wine spills and celebrity wines. Okay, in Canada, Mission Hill Winery, super famous winery if you're Canadian, They had one of their employees accidentally pumped out 20,000 bottles worth of wine into a drain. And this was the second time this employee has done that. Sounds suspicious. This is horrible. In Sonoma, a major brand dumped basically 500,000 bottles of wine into the Russian River. Just like whoosh, and it washes away. Yes, it was Cabernet. All right, so French winemakers battled the surplus by turning all of their wine into hand sanitizer. And there was a winery that makes Muscadine in North Carolina that also did that as well. And I'm kind of wondering, did they do that because there was a surplus or because that was a bad batch of Muscadine wine? And finally, my favorite one that I found this year was a winery in the Lambrusco region of Italy. Some weird malfunction happened where people were turning on their faucets and Lambrusco was coming out. Can you imagine getting this from a faucet? One thing that happened this year was a long time coming, and that was social awareness in the wine industry. Two big events spawned an entire movement that happened this year. One was the Netflix movie that came out called Uncorked. It's freaking adorable. It was a black lead wine movie. I don't think that's ever happened ever. And that created an entire movement in the industry that was pointing out the fact that we're a little bit lily white and we could use a little bit more diversity. Second thing that happened was this badass chick in New York published a book called Wine Girl, where she revealed some of the dark side about women in the wine industry. If you're a girl and you read some of these stories, they make you feel very, very uncomfortable. After Victoria James published her book, an entire group of women came forth pointing out some major issues in the wine education business. All in all, I think we've had a serious thirst for wine this year, and it has caused some people and some groups to do some very interesting things. A mostly naked man was found clinging to the bottom of a wine tanker, suckling it. Two brands have started doing wine in their program. Cracker Barrel and Taco Bell came out with a wine called Jalapeno Noir. No, they didn't send me a sample. They're not idiots. All right, y'all. That's basically my summary on year 2020. And until next time, drink safely and peace out.